I crawled out of bed this morning and after 2.5 hours sleep at the most, and got swooshed into a car, and we've come now to do a photo shoot for, is it the Telegraph? Oh no, it's the News of the World. Not glamorous. This is not glamorous. I'm flagging now. You know, I need an injection of caffeine and a good night's sleep.
Shell's long-term boyfriend Scott supports her decision to do a photo shoot for a tabloid newspaper.
She's getting paid loads of money for doing virtually nothing, and it's not really anything that the nation hasn't seen already by this point. So, in fact, there's actually clothes on, so I suppose. She's just doing the necessary. I mean, it would be foolish to turn it down, I think.
What do you think?
It's 11:30 on Sunday morning, and all the housemates have gathered for the first time since the grand finale 2 days ago for a very special Big Brother's Little Brother.
I love your dress. Was that a dress at all, though?
I'm gonna need your love. Don't you give me your love.
As the housemates prepare, Kate, the producer, has some news for the group.
Obviously, we all know Jason can't be here, which is he has basically decided that he needs to be with his family today. Obviously, we're very disappointed he can't be here, but if he wants to be with his family, that's cool.
Yeah. Is his family around, or is that just an excuse?
Do you know what? I'm not entirely sure.
Yeah. I think that's just an excuse, because everybody's gone home.
Yeah. I never went to the barbecue or the rap party just because I never wanted to be around the whole Big Brother thing. I had to get away from it. I just never felt like seeing all the other housemates. I had enough of them. I had 10 weeks cooped up with them. It's time for a little break.
Without Jason, the ex-housemates get into position for the start of the show.
Oh my God, we're going through the back to back, through the camera one.
Oh, we're going through the camera.
Welcome to the Big Brother's Little Brother reunion barbecue. All very exciting today.
After the show, a frenzy of signing begins, which is followed by a specially laid on barbecue. While the food heats up, some of the housemates find it difficult to let go.
In the house, do you reckon you were in character mode, or were you just being yourself?
You know, I'm not like down, you know, I didn't choose a role. I'm not an actor, you know, I just went in there and just tried to keep myself entertained, really. Nadia won, and you know, fair play to her, because I was trying to get rid of Nadia from day one anyway, you know, and regardless of her past, you know, if she told me she used to be a dude, I still would have tried to get rid of her anyway, as you saw this year, because she was like, you know, on the opposition kind of thing, you know.
Stuart and Michelle sneak away for their very first look behind the two-way mirrors in the house.
Should we just cruise in?
I think so.
Let's do it, dear. Oh, Big Brother house, this is Stuart. I can't imagine what it looks like.
What do you mean, Jake?
Well, it looks like something to me, but...
It looks like the place you've been living for the last 10 years.
Yeah, but... Like, this zone is,
What?
Like, where Nadia's always taking people's pants off.
I know, that's what it
was. And these are the cameras,
though. That's what it was, that's what I'm talking about.
Can you, like, hear voices and stuff in your head of, like, people running around?
See Jason bombing up and down.
Yeah. I can't see Jason bombing up and down, actually, and doing that chair thing.
It's just so easy to imagine, isn't it?
Yep.
Been our life for however long.
Can remember doing the Big Brother Idol up there with the seats on the grass. Mm. It finalises things.
That's exactly it.
It's like closure almost.
Yeah, yeah. The end. The greatest adventure of our lives.
Why did they love you so much in the house? Why did they vote?
I don't know, you tell me.
No, come on.
It's been 3 days since Nadia won Big Brother 5, and she's been working non-stop with TV and radio interviews, but she still finds time for a spot of shopping.
Right, Nadia, I pulled you off a rail of stuff. What is it you're actually looking for?
Something glamorous, something fab.
You don't like it, no?
No.
Is that all that she brought up?
Next stop for Nadia is London's Leicester Square for an appearance on MTV's TRL show. A crowd of fans have gathered to see her in the flesh.
It's going to be a big experience for me. I've never done before. I'm just kind of used to watching on TV, nothing else. So here I am. It's very exciting.
Nadia, can I have a picture with you, please?
Okay.
Where am I going? This way. Yeah. Oh my God! You
okay? Oh, my God. Keep the applause coming. AC, go! Nadia!
Well, it's good to have you here. Which housemate have you spent the most time with since you've left? Because I'm sure you've been very busy pressing everything.
I've seen everyone weekly. I've also had a well party in London, so I've been saying my name. And I've been Mark and Emma. And
I'm enjoying it, believe me. It's just I wish I could sort of relax more. I don't know exactly what's going on in me. But
I know!
Nadia has decided to sell her story to Heat magazine for a rumoured £30,000.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Okay.
I'm fine.
Yeah, you're still being followed around by a camera.
Yes, I am. They can't have enough of me. Look at the size of this hill. And I showed you that I loved you more than once. Yeah, I'm going to have to leave you now because this is an exclusive. From Heat to me, probably the thought. I had like three gorgeous hanky men on their pants for my cover. I was literally like, okay, what do I move? My elbow was like touching them all and their parts. But it was a very good fun, it was so funny.
Give me a hug here.
Oh my God.
Oh yeah. All right, here we are with the one and
only. Oh my God. Oh my God.
Baby.
So many different things for us due to like the, he, I know I'm aware that he looks really, really good. He's got a good sense of humour. He's got a very playful sense of humour.
It's Tuesday the 10th of August and Stuart and Michelle are enjoying their last evening in England before OK magazine fly them to Spain for some time alone together.
I think it'll be good because hopefully, well, I don't know if we'll be recognised or not, but...
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. Let's be cool if we're not, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, totally.
We might not even bump into that many people anyway, so it'll just be relaxed time.
Yeah, everything's been so weird that just this another, you know, adventure like this doesn't kind of feel out of the ordinary to me, you know? Does that make sense?
Yeah, but at the same time, it is another adventure.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah, of course.
Like, as most dudes know out there, we just, as a people, dudes just don't talk about their feelings that much. You know, guys have enough trouble just talking to their girls about their feelings and things.
I'm well up for some swimming as well.
Okay.
Like, last time I swam.
Well, I hope you got some swimming.
It's like Easter, I think. That'd be amazing. I think we need a toast to this holiday. So, to the holiday.
Cheers,
girl.
Jack.
Oh, my darling.
Did you just say that?
My darling.
This doesn't feel like a major step. It's more just about spending some time alone away from all the action and things. I'm totally looking forward to it though. It's gonna be good.
It's 1 week since the Big Brother finale, and Shell and Dan have decided to go back to their hometowns of Glasgow and Hull.
It's fantastic being back in Glasgow. I love it because it's properly home. It's just nice hearing Glaswegian voices, and yeah, it's lovely. It's lovely being back.
When you come back to your home, it's away from the merry-go-round.